flags right now.
The last one, the beach end, so it digs into the beach. We've taken that, we've pushed it hard into the beach, following in with the surf. What this will allow us to do is take containers and or vehicles from ships offshore, bring them onto the beach, drive them right off, and then pull right back off away from the shore.
And you're practicing today for the Trident Pier that you're going to be putting up.
What's that? Yes, right, yeah. We'll be putting an entire pier up just like that, except the pier will be anchored once we hit the beach with it. This right now is the Causeway Ferry. What we'll do with the ferry is we'll also be running a ferry to the beach and back, but all the other cargo will be loaded up off onto our pier and then driven onto the beach. And unloads onto that, and unloads onto like the LSV or the LCUs, and those ships take it to the Trident Pier. The Trident Pier is made up of 25 sections. Each section is 24 feet by 80 feet. So, 25 of those, and the RDF 17 of those. So.
And would you say this type of JLOTS exercise as a whole, the Trident Pier is like one of the three main ways we have of accessing this type of beach,
right? Yeah, that's true. We have the ferries, of course, the Navy and LCAS, and then the most importantly, of course, the Trident Pier, which is larger. Can roll more stock across it and survive higher sea shape.
Is that something we have to be careful about? Is the wave size, some safety?
Yes, once it hits a certain size, you have to shut it down and just not roll cargo across it, basically, for a while. It can survive into sea shape well above that, but usually it'll die down before that unless it's a severe storm.
Now, see, the people out there are going kind of high and low. I mean, what's the range?
It's
pretty steep out there.
3 or 4 feet up and down based on whatever the waves are doing. There's flexors in between the sections, so it allows it to bend with the waves.
James, it's starting to last week. I was working with the ship.